Welcome to Lighthouse Lessons. This is VBS Day 5. Let's go over what we learned the past couple of days. On Day 1, our medallion had the number 1 in it to remind us that God is the only one true God. He is great. And we went our way through Chameleon Cave and we made our way to Octopus Inlet. And our medallion for Day 2 has the big letter O in it to remind us that God is omniscient, omnipresent, and omnipotent. And then we made our way to the Great White Gulf. And our medallion had a big crown in it to remind us that God is ruler over everything and he is the one and only holy king. And then made our way to Jellyfish Lagoon. Our medallion has a big heart in the center to remind us that God is a loving savior and he's also Emmanuel, which means God with us. That was Jesus Christ we learned about. And now we're going to our last spot, Macaw Mountain. Before I reveal what our medallion is, we're going to actually figure it out by deciphering a cipher over here. Okay, so we have right here our cipher, and I'm just going to go through it really quick. The first number is 4. As we look in here, we see that a number matches up with each letter, and the number 4 has letter D right there. So that's our first clue of what our medallion has, is the letter D. The number 9 is right here and has the letter I on it. All right, the next number is 1. 1 is the letter A, it's right there. So here we are. And the number 13 is right there, it's the letter M. So that's our next one. So far we have dime. I'm pretty sure you can guess right now what it is. All right, number 15, we match it up with the letter O. The next letter is O. Then we have number 14, it's right there, right next to O. It's the letter N. And it has N right there. And the last one is 4, what we had right here at the beginning, and it is the letter D. All right, so that was me deciphering our cipher, and the word is diamond, right? That's what our medallion has today. I have it right here in my pocket. We're going to go ahead and put it on a treasure map. And our medallion, if you want to look closer, has a diamond right in the center. And this diamond reminds us about how valuable God is and how trustworthy he is and how we should love him and live for him. All right, there's the treasure chest. It's right there in the center. We're that close. Today we're going to learn about how God is like a diamond or more valuable than a diamond, because people wear diamonds because they are valuable and they are expensive and they mean a lot. God is worth much more than all the diamonds in the world. And why? Because he is amazing. And part of him being amazing is him being trustworthy. And we're going to learn more about God being trustworthy through reading about David and Goliath. I have a picture over here that you're going to be, I'll put up real quick so you can look at it as I tell the story. Okay, so here it is. It says God can be trusted in everything. And that's basically, mostly we're going to learn today is that God is trustworthy. He can be trusted in everything. That's David and there's Goliath. And let's get started on reading the story. It took place about 3,000 years ago. All right, so this is a story in the Bible about an epic battle between a guy named Goliath, he's right there, and a teenager named David, right? Goliath was a champion of the Philistine army. David was a young man who was an Israelite. The Philistine army had gathered for battle against the Israelite army. The Israelites were God's special people, and the Philistines were their enemy. The Philistines were standing on the mountain on one side, and the Israelites stood on the other side with a valley in between them. So they're fighting with each other. The great champion, Goliath, came out of the Philistine camp. He was over 9 feet tall. That's about as tall as this entire room from the floor to the ceiling. He was super, super tall. Every day for 40 days, Goliath would come between the two armies and shout to the Israelite army. He would taunt them and try to get someone to fight him. Goliath wanted the war between the two countries to be settled by just himself and one Israelite fighting. If the Israelite killed Goliath, then all the Philistines would be the Israelites' servants. But if Goliath killed one Israelite, then all the Israelites would have to be the servants of the Philistines. The leader of the Israelite army was King Saul. When he and his army heard Goliath's idea,
They were really, really afraid and really scared. Nobody was willing to fight against Goliath. Now, there was an Israelite family whose father was named Jesse. Jesse had 8 boys. The oldest 3 were in the Israelite army. Jesse asked his youngest son, a teenager named David, he's right here in our picture, to take some food to his brothers and to the other Israelite soldiers. After arriving, he ran to the front lines just as Goliath the giant was coming out with his usual taunt. All the men of Israel ran away when they heard Goliath. David saw all this and asked what was going to be done for the person who fought Goliath. He was really upset because he saw that Goliath was mocking the army of the living God and he was making fun of God. When the Israelites heard what David was saying, they took him to King Saul. David told Saul he would go and fight Goliath. Saul didn't think David would be able to fight him because David was only a teenager and he was really short and not as strong as Goliath. David told Saul he had taken care of sheep and fought off lions and bears and killed them. Goliath would be just like a lion or a bear. God had delivered David from the lion and the bear, and God would deliver him from Goliath as well. So Saul agreed for David to be the one to fight Goliath. He dressed David in his armor and helmet, but David wasn't used to them, and he didn't want to use them, so he took the armor off. Then it was time for David and Goliath to fight. Goliath came out cursing David and saying he was going to give David's flesh to the birds of the air and the beasts of the field. He was trying to scare David, but David was not intimidated by Goliath. David trusted in God because he knew who God is. God is faithful to his people, and God is stronger than an enemy. God would give David the strength. He told Goliath that even though Goliath came with a huge spear and sword, David came in the name of the Lord, the God of the army of the Israelites. David said God would deliver Goliath into his hand, and David would strike him down and cut off his head. He said the battle is the Lord's, and that meant the Lord was in control, and David was confident he would win with the Lord's help. Well, the battle began, and Goliath began to come toward David. But David did not run away like the other men did. He instead ran quickly toward Goliath, grabbing a stone and putting it into his sling. Right here we see that Goliath is armed to protect himself. He has a huge spear, and he has a sword right there. And David does not have the same armor that Goliath has. And the only thing he has is a little rock right there and his sling. So David comes out with his stone and his sling, and he slung it and struck Goliath smack dab in the middle of his forehead, and Goliath fell over and died. So with the Lord's help, David won the battle over the Philistines, and all the Israelites were so glad. Then David took Goliath's sword and cut off his head just as he said he would, and all the Philistine army ran away. The Israelites had won, and David stood strong in his trust of the Lord. David showed his trust in God even from this age when he was a teenager, because David knew God is faithful, perfect, powerful, great, good, and caring. David had mighty trust in God because he knew God is a powerful God. Knowing how great and powerful God is leads us to having big trust in our Creator. God wants you to have big trust in Him too. When something happens in life, even something really bad, and you don't understand why, trust in God and His character. If you have a big question in life, trust God's character. Remember that God is love, God is good, and God is perfect. Whether we understand a big question or a big circumstance or not, does not change who God is. Trust in Him. Okay, guys, that was the end of David and Goliath. Now we're going to go over to our animal pal for the day. We have Trusty the Macaw. He is a good friend, but God is the most treasured friend ever. God is trustworthy. That's what this says. So pirates, as we have right here, they were pretty mean people, but the true friend they had was their parrots, and that's what he has right here. He has the macaw who he trusted, and that was the pirate's friend. But as the pirates trusted their parrots to be their friend, we can trust God to be our friend. God wants us to trust Him the same way we trust a parent, or we trust friends, or we trust a teacher. We've been talking about how God is trustworthy, and He is the one we can trust the most. We can trust God because He's near to us, He's caring, and He's always truthful. The Bible says we can trust in God forever.